Hey everyone, let's start with this viral video of President Joe Biden at the G7 International Summit. Social media posts suggest that the group of global leaders were set to take a picture, but Biden lost focus and he just wandered off. The GOP even tweeted an article making that claim. But here's the thing, that video making the rounds is just one angle that doesn't give the full context of what was happening. Here's the full video, and from another angle, it shows he's greeting the parachute jumpers that just landed. Check out both videos side by side. He greets them, gives them a thumbs up, and is then tapped on the shoulder for the picture. Let's move on to this fake press release making the rounds on social media. It claims to be a statement by former President Donald Trump after Hunter Biden's conviction on Tuesday. The phony statement says that he'll save Hunter Biden after he gets elected. However, Trump did release a statement, but this is the real one. It doesn't make any mention of stepping in to help Hunter Biden. And finally, we're looking into a remark made by President Joe Biden at a gun safety conference. It refers to gun dealers' ability to be sued.
The only industry in America that has immunity are gun dealers.
Here's what we found. Based on a 2005 federal law, there are legal protections that can shield them from some lawsuits. If a gun is used in a crime, the manufacturer cannot be held responsible for that crime. That's all to make sure those companies aren't put out of business. But that doesn't mean they can't be sued. The law does have exceptions. For example, manufacturers and dealers can be held liable if they knowingly break a law, like illegally selling a weapon. Helping you get the facts, I'm National Investigative Correspondent John Cardinelli.